This digital annual conference comes at a very special moment. We all know what is happening in the world. Somehow, the impossible seems to be possible.
The construction sector in general takes 50% of natural resources and produces 25% of carbon emissions. We think that every street in Paris can be transformed if we put pedestrians and bikes in the center and not cars.
And it's all about greening and about quality of projects. And it's very interesting that you say, well, the price of the land is not the most important anymore. And you proved what I said, the impossible is now possible. I mean, the use of the public space is now really changing in Paris.
And the trend was heel duidelijk. Uitbreiding aan de rand was uit. Binnenstedelijk bouwen, dat was de norm.
Een populatiegroei in de stad. Die je op de x-as ziet, dus positief.
Maar wat mij betreft geldt dat voor Nederland breed. Dat is dat we natuurlijk een steeds zwaardere claim op schaarse ruimte hebben. We willen heel veel met die ruimte. We willen niet alleen woningen bouwen.
Je ziet dat mobiliteit daar een belangrijke rol in speelt in het dagelijks leven van mensen en voor bedrijven. Die natuurlijk ook zien dat hun mensen productiever zijn, happier zijn met die combinatie, die gevarieerdheid.
Cities are dynamic beasts. They change over time, and the way we've built our cities 50, 60 years ago and the way we're using them today has significantly changed.
It didn't just become successful on its own and as we know it now. It took years of considering how to make a place active and dynamic.
The inclusion of the citizens is very important, and we use things like, what do people dream about the place should be in the future? What do we want to create together with other people?
To create a new imaginary that can sort of guide us delivering on all these aspects that we discussed this morning. So cultural placemaking, an ecological agenda, and also densifying the city as we must.